When I was elected to be the JAINA vice president, one automatically becomes convener of the next convention. I wanted to make sure that Rakesh Bhai attends my 2005 convention in San Francisco. I did not know much about Rakesh Bhai, except the transformation which I had witnessed in my cousin, Sunil Desai. He would go out and eat, you know, just about everything, eat till late night, like many Bombayites. After dinner, you gotta go out till 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. Last time, that's in 2004, when I went out to eat with Sunil, he ordered Jain food and would not eat out at night. His wife told me that he has changed ever since he started satsang with Rakesh Bhai. I was now curious to meet with Rakesh Bhai and learn more about him. I had heard many good things about him through others, including that some of the sadhu sadhvijis had great respect for him. So I used my position. Normally, this Sunil told me it's very hard to meet with him, but I said, look, I have a chance. I can go see him as a JAINA president and request him for his attendance. So he said, look, you have to make an appointment through Amit Gala. I said, what? JAINA president has to make an appointment to see a dignitary? I said to myself that he must be a big shot for me to go to someone. Little did I realize then how precious his time was. Amit told me that Gurudev is leaving for Singapore and Hong Kong trip tomorrow at 6:30, but he will meet me at 5 p.m. at his residence. Sunil, my cousin, was very eager to drive me to his place. He would do anything just to meet Bapaji. Sunil bowed down to him with great respect. I was dumbfounded. I just casually bowed down to him. To me, more respect than that was reserved for sadhu sadhvijis only. One of many meets I was carrying, a lot of baggages. In January 2005, we sent an official JAINA invitation to Rakesh Bhai, like many other dignitaries. We had come to know that usually about 100 plus people accompany him all the time. When Rakesh Bhai gave his first lectures, the room was full. There was only standing room. This was very unusual. It was usually dignitaries like Gurudev Chitrapanuji, Jin Chandraji Maharaj, Dhiraj Bhai Pandit, Bharil Ji, and other well-known names that have been coming to JAINA for many conventions. For the afternoon session, word had spread about Rakesh Bhai's talk. More people had lined up to occupy the room than its capacity. The decision was made to give additional room and combine two rooms to one. This way, we could accommodate all. Later on, complaints started pouring in from other dignitaries that their attendance had dwindled and some had as few as only three. Quite a shock to the programming committee. Unfortunately, I didn't have a time to attend his satsang, but I heard all good reviews about it. In 2007 JAINA convention, JAINA decided to keep Rakesh Bhai's lecture in the main hall and only one lecture, so there was no competition with others. The main hall was practically full as opening ceremony, quite an attendance. My first encounter. In June 2007, I had gone to Toronto to attend Waterworks exhibition for my business. I came to know that Rakesh Bhai was in town and there'll be satsang in the evening. I decided to go to the satsang and also meet with Rakesh Bhai as JAINA president to talk about convention. As he was getting down from the car, I made it a point to meet with him and exchange greetings. I came to know that he had 2 days open in his hand after JAINA convention and LA program. I requested him to visit us in Waco, Texas. He said if his health permits, he might come. I was happy to hear the good news. Was it a bhakti or was it a ego satisfaction? I know people would die to be in that position. I was feeling good. Later on, at the 2007 JAINA convention, something happened. I went to the front door to personally escort him. No JAINA president has ever done that to any dignitaries. I also sat next to Rakesh Bhai, even asking one of the respected dignitaries to move over so I could sit next to Rakesh Bhai. In the past, I would never do such thing, but I don't know what had happened to me at that time. I never been so rude to others, especially dignitaries. All of a sudden, I was high. After JAINA convention, something else was happening to us. Some strange power was acting on us. We made the decision to go to LA and meet up with him. You know how expensive last minute tickets are. But reasoning was being thrown out of the window. Our heart was ruling over our mind. As soon as we landed at LA airport, we rented the car and drove as fast as I could to LA Jain Center. Wanted to see Rakesh Bhai and attend the satsang. At the end of the session, he saw us, because we were still in street clothes, that's jeans, etc., not white clothes. He told us that he was expecting us. He had told Amit that we'll be coming to see him. Satsang at LA were different for us than elsewhere. In the past, we would skip bhakti and attend the satsang, sitting at the back of the hall so I could yawn, doze off, or just attend to phones. Here, I sat in the front and shut off my phone and joined from beginning of the bhakti. I found satsang to be meaningful with the hidden messages. At times, I felt that they were for me. This was also a very critical time for me. I had spent over 10 years serving JAINA, starting as a director and progressing every 2 years to reach to the pinnacle. I had also handed over my presidency at the 2007 convention. There were no more challenges, no more goals to be achieved. Life was going to be empty. But the miracle had happened for me. One hand, I was giving up all the competitive post, illusive power. And by the other hand, I was being pulled by some magical touch. I was falling in love with Pujya Rakesh Bhai. All of a sudden, my life was filled with Pujya Rakesh Bhai. It is tough to give a power position. People who step down still try to hang on to the position with their ideas and egos and make life miserable for the upcoming president. Lucky for me that Pujya Rakesh Bhai was there to hold me in his arms and bring me to the senses. Many feel that I came in close contact with Pujya Rakesh Bhai because of JAINA presidency. To those, I will say I had been working for the past 12 years looking for him. I was searching but did not know what I was looking for. But I also feel that it is not those 12 years, but must have had the connection since Bhavobhav. It is his Krupa. Many JAINA presidents have come and gone, but I don't believe anyone has been affected as I have been. JAINA was only the nimit. His Krupa, my time was right for each other. Our Parishan experience. Since last few years, we have been always going to India to observe Parishan and be with Babji, Lalita Bhai Masatiji. In 2007, we went to India as usual for Parishan, but this time, none of our bags showed up. By the time we came home, it was 2 a.m. It was very hard to sleep. We were in Santa Cruz. Planes were flying all over us. We were close to the airport. We wanted to go attend satsang, see Bapaji. Puchho na kaise maine rain bitai ek pal jaise ek yug bita yug bite mohinin na aaye. No sooner it was 6 o'clock, we just left. We wanted to be first one to be in Dadar. This was the first time we attended satsang here, starting with Snatra Puja. Funny thing happened. Luckily, our bags that were delayed would not show up for the next 2 days. So we decided to make up this opportunity and end all satsang of Pujya Rakeshji. After enjoying the satsang for 2 full days, we were now in dilemma. All our relatives, friends, start telling us, why don't you stay here? Don't go to Baroda this time. You go every year. Stay back. Should we continue observing our parishion here with Pujya Rakeshji, or should we go to Lalita Bhai Masutiji in Baroda? As per our plan, they were waiting for us. We didn't know what to do. But we went to see Pujya Rakeshji. He read our mind and told us that we should proceed to Baroda and be with Masutiji, for whom we had come for. He said that Santni Vani Amulya Che, go on for what you have come for. He was also kind enough to give us 2 books to read, Santni Vani and Atma Sadhana. He suggested that in between Vyakhyan and other daily activities of parishion, I should read these books if time permits. I finished Atma Sadhana as it was written by Jain monk first. I kept the Santni Vani for the end. I did not feel comfortable reading it, as it was not written by the Jain monk or the Jain scholar. I felt I would attract Mithyatva by reading something other than Jainism. But I read cover to cover Santni Vani. I found the message to be very enlightening. My respect for Pujya Rakeshji started increasing for him to show me that the truth is universal. I also learned more about Vipassana, made a vow to attend the Vipassana course at Pujya Gurudev's advice. All along, I've been reading many, many books, but what those 2 books give the message to me, nobody could have done except what Guru could have done for me. After parishion, we attended Shibir at Dharampur. This was a unique experience. From morning till evening, spirituality was flowing all over. Lodging and boarding were great. All mumukshu took care of us. And some of the trustees were telling us about their life experiences with Pujya Gurudev. If it was not enough, we were blessed to be in company of Gurudev's mother, Rekha Ben. She told us many stories about Gurudev, not only as mother, but as devotee. We wanted to meet with Gurudev. We asked Amit, we want to meet with him, but our meeting kept getting postponed for the next 4 days. His unique way of trying us. Day of our departure comes, 9:15. Amit seeks me out, says, Gurudev wants to meet with you. We were very happy that finally he gave us the time. He asked us, when are you leaving? We said, we are flying out this evening. So we have booked the morning, we have booked afternoon ticket. So we are leaving in a few minutes. We were just waiting to meet with you. He said, stay back. I'll take care of you. You won't miss your train. You won't miss your flight. I'll make sure somebody goes with you and you won't miss it. A night before, Maulik had brought me puja clothes. He said that Gurudev has sent this for you for to do puja in the morning. What? I am Stanakwasi. I had worn dhoti only once. To perform Mahamastak Abhishek Puja in 2006 Jaina Yatra. One of the trustee, Ratan Lalji, from Dharampur helped me wear dhoti. I participated in Snatra Puja. Pujya Gurudev lovingly corrected some of my mistakes. He knew Sthanakwasi don't know anything about puja. What kindness and love. Later on, he gave us an opportunity to do the opening ceremony of the sales office in the administrative block. With so much of his krupa that he decided to shower us with the highest honor one can give to someone who has just started interacting with him. We were in tears. While he was inspecting sales office, I grabbed Atmasiddhi Vivechan written by him and requested his autograph on the first volume. He just looked at me. He said, no, I cannot write my name on it. Rather, he wrote a message for me. And he grabbed the rest of the three volumes and gave it to me. And he walked out. I went to the sales counter, to Jayanti Singhvi, and started paying. She said, no, no. Bapaji is taking care of this for you. I said, wow, what a gift. I started looking around. I found a picture of Bapaji. I wanted his autograph. So I ran after him. He walked so fast. And I was dumbfounded, I don't know. But Jayanti said, here, take the pen, go, go. So I ran after, go to Bapaji, say, please, can I have an autograph on this? And he writes, Murli Matra. Such a precious moment. It reminds me. I still remember those moments. Din jo pakheru hote rakh leta pinjre mein palta unko jatan se palta unko jatan se moti ke daane deta sine se rehta lagaye yaadin jaye bite dinon ki jaake na aaye jo din dil kyun bhulaye unhe. Murli Matra. It was such an appropriate message for me. I had attended many lectures of pandits, sadhu sadhvijis. I read many books. I thought I knew it all. But spiritually, I was bankrupt. I was all empty within. Last July, I went through a surgery. This was the first time after many years of pollution I could not go to India. I was disappointed that we would not be able to go, nor I could do my usual top of a tie. I feel my ego was also hurt. I could not say any more that we've been going to India for many years. My physical condition would not allow. So I wrote to Bapaji and told him my dilemma. He sent me specific instructions. The spiritual of 2008 was the best of all the spiritual experiences I had all these years. Journey in 609 up was unforgettable. The day started out with web Snatra Puja for me. It is something extraordinary, not coming from Murti Puja tradition, followed by satsang and other activities keeping us fully occupied spiritually throughout the day. I did not miss India, even though I was not with Sadhu Sadhviji. I was in Waco. For those who know Waco, we were only company to each other, me and my wife, and Bapaji with Yogi Savagra at the webcast. Someone asked us, we have attended many lectures of Sadhu Sadhvijis, various pundits, and read many books. Was it this? What was it that we find differences with Rakesh Bhai? Why are we going after him? Our answer was, when we go to India, our effects of pollution stays with us only till the time we are there with Sadhu Sant. As soon as our flights take off for US, our minds go back to routine. This pollution, though not physically with Gurudev, even in India, but its spirituality has lasted longer than before. Matter of fact, we are still under trance. We had been searching for the truth, the light, but still not found. I was searching for the Holy Grail. Those who are in stock market, they know the term Holy Grail. One trick so you can master the stock market. But I found my Holy Grail in Pujya Bapaji. My first yatra. I had done many yatra with Jaina, led some yatras also, but I now feel that really was not a yatra. It was more of a sightseeing, paribrahman. So, after having this experience in 2007, I joined Bapaji for the first time with Idar Yatra. We have been to Idar with Jaina, but it was not yatra. It was more of a trip or Brahman. Mind and body were there, but spirituality was lacking to go with it. This yatra was different. Bus full of mumukshus, like-minded people, led by Bapaji. Feelings and vibrations were different. The evening satsang was followed by Ras Garba and Dandiya Ras. It was a charged atmosphere. But somehow or other, I just wanted to sit back and felt like going into meditation. I was looking for a place to sit down. From nowhere, Amit Bhai shows up and asks me to sit in the front. I sat on the floor in the front, but he asked me to sit next to Bapaji on the side table. I was reluctant. He said, no, it's okay. I just listened what he said. I sat next to Bapaji and closed my eyes and did my vipassana, went into meditation. It was the best experience I've had so far. I don't know what the world was thinking. I don't know what everybody was saying. What a crazy man. No respect, nothing. Till this day, I wonder how it happened. But that was the best experience I've had so far, because I just had come from Vipassana training only weeks before. It was truly Bapaji's Krupa that I experienced what I experienced. From Yatra, we came back to Dharampur to attend the year-end Shibir. Bapaji had announced earlier that those who attend Sadhana Bhatti will not be able to attend Ganga Sati Shibir. We had heard about Ganga Sati and Vijayan Shamkare during one of the satsang, and we were very curious. It really interested us. We did not want to miss that. So we opted for Seva of Health Camp. Later, Bapaji's kindness, he made some changes from usual sadhanapati and told us that those who want to attend sadhanapati would be able to attend Gangasati Shibir. I found an excuse and said that we would like to do seva. Really, in the back of my mind, I had a different motive. I did not want to mix up my vipassana technique with other methods of sadhanapati. How arrogant. The very guru who recommended me to do vipassana, I was going against his wishes and commands. How egoistic I was. Later on, I realized my mistakes when we were asked to read Uttarajan Sutra. It mentioned that if guru tells you to do something, no matter what, you must obey. Even a slight request from you for anything contrary is an insult to the guru, and you could be deprived of guru's kripa. When I read that, I realized my mistake. It took me some time and lots of courage for me to tell him the truth and be ready for the consequences. Papaji is very kind. Pratishtha at our home. Despite all of our shortcomings, Papaji was kind enough to honor us with the Pratishtha Motso. He agreed to come to Waco, Texas, which is in the middle of nowhere. 2 hours of drive from major city like Dallas or Austin, and only one Jain family in the whole town. Papaji put Waco on the world map with good vibrations. This show will wipe off some of the David Koresh's horrible event where over 80 adults and children had died in federal encounter. But before Bapaji's visit, miracles started happening. Our house has been shifting so badly that no contractors are willing to touch our home to repair it. They're either afraid to mess it up or being sued. Our front door has so badly shifted, we had to cut it many times to line up properly. Finally, it even couldn't be opened up for Bapaji's visit. We had to bring everybody through the garage door. Luckily, we found a willing manufacturer to produce and install the glass door for us in 2 weeks, where there was darkness, where the doors were closed. Now the daylight filled our front entrance and we could open our doors. Just like light was coming in our closed hive, our heart was now lightening up with Bapaji's Krupa. All major appliances in 1 week started going down. The old microwave had to be replaced, indicating we were going to get new vibrations. The dishwasher had to be replaced. Just stop working to start the cleansing process. Fresh. The stove had to be replaced to ignite stronger and longer lasting fire within us. Even the TV in the living room, view to the outside world, stopped working. We were supposed to be going within. My son came home and says, "Now, Dad, you gotta have a TV." I said, "Okay, you wanna watch it, you can bring it. I have nothing to do with it." The weather was so bad before Bapaji was gonna come. It was foggy for 2 days. And we were worried, how are we going to bring him? Because even during the daytime, you couldn't see. Night was different. But the day when we started, we left at about 5 o'clock, thinking it will take 1.5 hour. No, it took 4:30, left 4:30. And I was driving. And people from Austin followed me, luckily. I had just changed the tires. All 4 tires had changed. And about 30 miles from airport, 5:25, Papaji's flight was coming at 6:15. One tire went broke. I said, what a test. what's going to happen now? Somebody else will bring him to Waco. We would miss this opportunity. Luckily, Rajiv Bhai and Mayur Bhai were there right behind us. They saw us, stopped. I was just going nuts. I picked up the phone, tried to call dealership to see if we could send somebody. And those two guys tried to help me. Couldn't find the tire to get, you know, for Lexus is a funny tire. They tried to take it out. And I walked across and ran and got somebody to change my tire. Luckily, I was able to make it to the airport by 6:25, 6:30. Flight was delayed. Papaji tells me that we were on the runway in Dallas for about half an hour. So thank God. He was just waiting for me. And we met him. My hands were trembling. I couldn't believe that Bapaji finally in Dallas. Bapaji also sent two Atmarpit to our rescue before Pratishtha, so that we don't miss out on any important preparations for the Pratishtha. He knew we haven't been to any Pratishtha, so we're going to make blunders. Through Bapaji's Krupa, we have felt life-moving experience, never experienced like this before. Pratishtha went very smoothly. We felt like never felt before. I have participated as Jaina president, as Shravak also, in many Pratishtha, but never had such vibrations, such feelings. Previously, in our small room, we had brought Parasnas Murti. Now, we have Kruparu Dev, Param Kruparu Dev, and Bapaji in our hearts, in our mandir. Our Pratishtha also was followed by a short visit to Dallas Sangh. Even from a short visit, Bapaji has made a huge impact over Dallas Sangh. The evidence you will see later on. My younger brother Gautam and his wife and his kids who are on the fence has become a believer. He will be soon joining us. One more Daftary clan to join the Mumukshu group. After Bapaji left, we missed all the energy, the vibrations and excitement. Vacuum was created at home after everyone left home. We just wanted to run to him. We couldn't sleep. It was Saturday. Phoenix trip was almost canceled, but Tuesday morning, we decided to drop everything and book the ticket at the last minute. We knew we'll meet Bapaji in Phoenix and even have the lab of his satsang on Tuesday evening. Our flights were delayed. We did not even wait for the baggage to arrive, just rented the car and flew off to the hotel to attend his satsang. Just in time. Was it to attend his satsang, or was he pulling us, or were we drawn in his love for us? Bapaji, we want to continue following you all the way to the final destination, point of no return. Please don't leave us now that we have found you. Forgive us for our mistakes, but help us grow and take out our dosha so we can go with you and be in shunya. We love you, Bapaji, Param Pujya Gurudev. No words can thank you enough for what you've done for both of us. I like to conclude. Gurudev, aapke charno ka
मैं पूजा करने आया हूँ, चरणों में भेंट चढ़ाने को खुद ही लेकर आया हूँ। गुरुदेव गुरुदेव।